Anybody have it? Go ahead, Woody.
Well, probably somebody, if there's strong man house, considering the, for this, the first line of strong man, that is easy to make somebody to be possible. Those that are not, who live in every season, provide against the sellers, great weight, and those sitting around, provide against the sellers, those bad.
And so, when there is no weakness, there must be a divine power in the position. Right, and so, a house, the Bible cannot change. And so, we can talk about this on the spiritual level, we can talk about this on the physical level, or natural level. Right, and so, in the natural, we can talk about our family as a house, we can talk about me as a house, like the life of a preacher that is called, he must live in a house of faith. Right, and so, the unfortunate part is many of us, stop building a house on a faulty foundation. Right, and so, there is no foundation, there is no agreement from the foundation. Why? Many times because we have not been willing to sacrifice when it's really to begin to build a house on a firm foundation. And then what Pentecost has never taught is that even though we come to Christ, we have to go back and recognize some stuff. And so even many of us that have come to Christ are still living on a faulty foundation. Because we haven't been taught that we have to go back and correct the wrong. One of the things that get newcomers to Christendom is the fact that nobody ever teaches them that when you come in, it's good that you came in, but now you got to pay the recompense for all the sins you have been. And so when the recompense comes, amen, many times we have to talk a trait about what it means, recompense for pay that. Now, we're about God, we're saying, right, when I live my life to you, that everything was going to change. But God says there is a payback that has to happen.
Jesus.
And if we're not taught that or trained, then we get the misconception that everything is just going to change by osmosis. But that's not true. And so it says that any kingdom divided by, he called it, we look at the translation, it says by civil war, internal, there's some things going on even with both of us right now. Right? And so, because we're not in agreement, that means that we're doing it. Because a town or a family splintered by healing will fall apart. And if Satan is casting out Satan, he is divided and fighting against himself. His own kingdom will not survive. And if God is empowered by Satan, what about their own exorcism? They cast out demons too, so they will condemn you for what you have said. But if I am casting out demons by the Spirit of God, then the kingdom of God has arrived among you. For who is powerful enough to enter the house of a strong man by Satan and burn his goods? Only someone even strong. Someone who could tie him up and implant his house. And so by agreement, we get that power. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When we stand in agreement with God, he relinquished that power and authority to us and gives us the ability now to go into the strong man's house. The two witnesses are that the Spirit is the mouth of God, and now you will go in and take back what you could believe. Amen. Amen. But when there is no agreement, there is a division. Amen. But look at John chapter 3 and verse 9.
And this is the life of coming to the
And the people love the darkness because of their the people love darkness more than light. And so, while I'm close to this, when there is no suffering, we choose to stay in darkness. And we choose to stay in darkness because we, in reality, we love darkness greater than light. Because light now means that there's more people. Light means more to be in light. And now, so then, I have to change some things about me. I have to learn to come into agreement with a different set of values. I have to learn to come into agreement with a different set of beliefs. And oftentimes, we don't want to do the work or put in the work that it takes to come into agreement with something different, something new. And so, we never find ourselves truly walking in the agreement with the Father. And so, we'll start out with, and it says, can two walk together in the same direction except they agree? And so, I submit to us tonight, there is no way in the 21st century we can walk with the Holy Spirit if we're not going in the same direction. And so, truth be told, many of us are going in one direction, and the Spirit is trying to take us in another direction. And so, tonight, understand that there is power in agreement. To agree with what the Father has laid before you. To agree with his love. To agree to walk hand in hand with the Spirit. And so Jesus says that if you walk in agreement with me, and I walk in agreement with you, it's in that place that the power comes.
Wow.
That was the body of the Mass Chapter 2. They were all together in one room and one accord. And suddenly, like a mighty motion of wind, the Spirit came. And so there are people tonight that you desire to walk in agreement God's way for.